You're watching Channel Austin, East by Southeast Spoken Word Showcase. I am Selah Vie, and I'm here with John McElhenney. How are you?
Hey, I'm great. How are you?
Good. Glad to have you on the show.
Thank you.
Is this your first time?
It is my first time here.
How did you hear about it?
I know that some of the writer friends of mine had posted it on Facebook.
Really?
And so I saw the logo and saw Spoken Word, and I've just been doing a little bit of that, recording myself in that way. And trying to put it up on the web, so it looked like a great opportunity.
Awesome. So you do poetry over music?
Yeah, I usually put music beneath the poetry. Today I'm going to play guitar while I read. I'm also a musician. So
awesome. How long have you been doing that for?
Which part?
Whichever part. Yeah, you like to
music since I was about 10.
Okay.
And poetry probably since my 20s.
Really? Yeah. Awesome. So what pieces did you bring to share with us today?
Well, so I'm working on a new collection called Making Love to Other Women.
Okay.
I'm recently divorced. Okay. 3 years ago, and so this is sort of my exploration of what love means today in the, you know, sort of modern relationship.
In the society?
It's my own little Sex in the City.
Really? I'm curious to see your input on that.
Yeah.
That's what I like about poetry. You get to see a view into other people's thoughts and feelings. And what else is that? Anything else did you bring?
It's three poems in that series.
So is it a book or a CD?
It's going to be, but of course it's still in progress.
All right, awesome.
They're being written as they happen.
So we get our first little glimpse here on Channel Austin.
Exactly. This is an exclusive.
Well, let's check John out, Austin, Texas.
She is here. She is solid, quiet, contemplative. She is natural, earthly, beautiful. She is touchable and lightly scented. She is seeking God in her life, and she is not afraid to dream or wonder leap. She is snuggleable, helpable, rubbable. She glows without adornment or makeup. She can stretch and pull and compress. She can sing and play. She is alone, and she is here. She knows breathing together as an ecstasy. She can express love by holding hands. She is not afraid to be in love. She is ready to go. She is willing to travel with me. She is aware of her power and beauty, and she doesn't need anything from me. She can express her longing without fear, and she breaks and cries and repairs. She can accept love even when sad or mad, and she knows her disappointments are mostly her own. She is unafraid to ask for her needs and wants. She understands dirt and children and pets. She can thrive in chaos as well as peaceful quiet. She can be still. She is flexible in body, mind, and spirit. She knows she is here. She may not be looking for me. She calls out the inspirational in me. She understands joining. She has sacred practices. She is expressing. She is not tired. She expects the best in everyone, and she celebrates the simple things easily. She is just out of my frame of view. She is near, and she is here. She will not be a projection that I must create. She shows up fully formed and empowered. She dances when she arises in the morning. She is gentle and kind. She does not call attention to herself, and she is unimpressed. She has a warmth that is infectious. She makes me smile and laugh. She has ways of expressing herself. She is open, and she is here. She cannot be captured or tracked. She is random. She is not what she seems. She strips me of my languages and tools. She is not afraid of big ideas. She is an intoxicant and a stimulant. She is self-aware. She comes in many forms. She is focused and fascinated. She is wearing functional shoes. She's an exploratory being. She's a happy camper. She is easy in the silences. She is left to go outside into the sun. She is no longer here. Neither am I. That was the sort of the first one of this whole series. Kind of started it off imagining the person that I would be looking for, perhaps in another relationship. This is a new one called Beautiful Shoes. She knew what she wanted. Fear and excitement can seem as the same. And in this moment, there was no mistaking the flutter from the fever. There would be no flight except into the snare of my lips and bed and breath. Knowing, wanting, and getting are very different states. And in the state of getting, the little black dress was simple and sexy and expendable. Any description here would break the spell, spoil the mystery, and the mysterious sacred journey of lovemaking. As she was putting the beautiful shoes back on, I couldn't help but watch, fascinated. The snare released, the quarry smiling and unhurried, her legs now moving with a new tremor, released, relaxed, satisfied for a brief moment, we were together. We are not. And the afternoon becomes a wash. Memories and smells overwhelm all obligations in my daydream stare. Out the window, I notice movement in the grass, and I notice my sleepiness, and I return to the bed, alone. And this is the last of the three. It's called Twist of the Hip. This one has a little more musical interludes. It was written while I was sitting in Strange Brew watching a musical concert. I don't need a woman. I crave a woman who knows and wants to love deeply, fearlessly, without regret. I can pick her out of a crowded bar. The one out of 30 women there, I imagine she is putting out her vibes and that she is looking at me too. In the lights and live music, she is probably just watching the crowd, but there she is, the one woman for me within this tight radius. We could both be lucky. So much information in the way a woman moves to music. Even from a chair, it's the same way she will make love in the world outside. Her dance is even more important. Is her step and life filled with sensuous motion? From the body flows the soul. They cannot hide from one another. She cannot hide from me either. I will ask. I will know. But will I press into dark places without request? But her body has a love language I am eager to learn, and her spiritual state will be laid bare. In a single glance and the twist of a hip, the path forward is open and necessary. Yet, I still know that all of this, poetry is projection. She is warm, willing, and at a show. On some early Saturday evening, she moves and her signals wash over me. That's it.